Hi friends, and welcome back to Parshati's Pulmonology. And today's part 5 of Pulmoradio Wines. And today is a very important allergical sign, that is golden S sign, or also known as reverse golden S sign. So the sign golden S sign or reverse golden S sign was introduced by Ross Golden, as the name goes, in 1925. He was a very famous radiologist who first attributed his signs to bronchogenic carcinoma. So what is the definition? So it is mainly seen on chest x-ray posterior entry view as a right upper lobe collapse with hilar enlargement. Okay, so the sign is used mainly when there is a right upper lobe collapse associated with hilar enlargement. So what exactly the sign means and why it is all known as golden S sign, or also known as reverse golden S sign. On my left, on the left of the screen, as you can see, there is a right upper lobe, there is a minor fissure which separates the right upper lobe and mid lobe, and the major fissure which separates mid and the lower lobe. Okay, so as you can see the minor fissure, here, if you please follow my cursor, it is not exactly a S shape. Okay, it's all more or less parallel or a straight line. But what happens in golden S sign, come to the image on the right side of the screen, as you can see there is a S sign or a reverse S sign here. Okay, this is known as golden S sign. So why exactly it happens? Follow the red color cursor. Here the part, this is a minor fissure. Okay, golden S sign is mainly representing the minor fissure. The red color sign is concave inferiorly and the green color is convex inferiorly. Okay, suppose when there is an right upper lobe collapse, okay, suppose there is a collapse of this green color part, so the down purple one moves up. So because of that, there is a, when there is a flat line, if there is a collapse of the right upper lobe, so it goes up. So there is a formation of golden S sign, also known as reverse S sign, because it is a sign of a reverse. It's not a straight S sign, it's a reverse S sign. Why it happens? Because when there is a cases of endobronchial obstruction, in cases of bronchogenic carcinoma, when there is an obstruction of a right upper lobe bronchus, so it leads to upper lobe collapse. So it causes a minor fissure to go up. Okay, as you can see, the minor fissure has gone up and there is an enlargement of the hilum. This enlargement is because of the mass. Okay, because of mass, there is a hilar enlargement associated with the right upper lobe collapse. Okay, got it? And the same in the, and on the under contrary part, on the left side, if there is a collapse, right, left upper lobe collapse, we call it as Lefelicher sign. Okay, which we'll cover in the next coming part. So what are the causes of golden S sign? As I have already told you, bronchogenic carcinoma, that is endobronchial growth causing collapse of the right upper lobe with hilar enlargement leading to this sign, or it could be hilar lymphadenopathy when the obstruction of the right upper lobe bronchus could be even from the outside. Okay, it could be because of a hilar enlargement in cases of sarcoidosis or tuberculosis, or even in case of malignancy. Okay, metastasis to lymph nodes can cause lymph node enlargement causing right upper lobe bronchus obstruction, leading to right upper lobe collapse, or in cases of, even in cases of primary mediastinal tumors causing right upper lobe collapse leading to golden S sign. Okay, so understood, right upper lobe collapse with hilar enlargement causes minor fissure to go up. It will be the shape of a reverse golden S sign. That is the main logic behind why it was named as golden S sign. Okay, and these are the various causes: bronchogenic carcinoma, hilar lymphadenopathy, metastasis, and mediastinal tumors. Okay. Thank you all for patient listening. If you have any doubt, please leave it in the comment section. If you like the video, or if you like, you are gaining any knowledge, please support this and please like, share, and subscribe the channel. Okay, thank you. I will be coming back in the next week with the Lefelicher sign, that is a contrary part of the right upper lobe collapse. And Lefelicher sign, we have left upper lobe collapse. I'll be coming with that sign in the next video. Thank you. Thank you all for patience listening.